Hair to Toes Beauty Tips on BCTV is supported by A Beautiful Transformation Salon.
Hey, how's it going, everyone? My name is Jean Esther, a local artist here in Reading. And today, I'm going to teach you guys how to, I'm going to show you guys how to paint this basically little sandal template. But on it, we're going to do a beautiful beach scene with a pelican somewhere in the middle. Okay, very simple. All right, first step, coming right up. Okay, guys, so let's begin. First thing I like to do is I like to kind of split my plank into two. So I like to know where the halfway point of my piece will be. So I'm gonna start with a light color. And this is just like a beige, very simple. And basically I'm gonna split it up right about, right about here. That's gonna be my halfway point for my horizon line. That could be, so down here is gonna be my water, and up here is gonna be more so my sky, okay? Now, we're painting with on a wood surface, okay? So really looks poor, so it absorbs a lot of the paint, so it kind of dries a little quicker than you'd expect. So first thing, let's start with the top sky and work our way down. Or, you know what? We can start from the bottom or our light color first and work our way up. So either option works, but for the sake of preserving my brush, I'm gonna start with the lighter color first. So almost like where the horizon line sets a little bit, right about here. All right, so I'm gonna start down towards the bottom, right about here. See how dry it gets real quick. So just be aware of that when you're painting. And the first thing I'm doing is just kind of giving it a good initial layer, and I'm going to add a little bit of that sand color to it too, just to lighten it up, just to kind of add a little bit of sunset feel to it, so it's not just blue color here. Now I'm going to add a little bit of that sky color, somewhere around there. Too is like, say for example, if you're feeling comfortable and you want to kind of see where the darkest of the, how dark you want the blue to become, you can throw it on top. And then what you want to do is make sure you combat it with some white as you go down. So. Sometimes I kind of jump it down a little bit. If I like what I'm seeing, and plus since the paint is drying so fast, I can actually start to really throw in some clouds, right? And the idea is, while the paint's still kind of wet, I can kind of throw a cloud in there and let it fade in to some of this background, right? And then the areas that are still a little wet are going to be my brightest areas. So I can do another one here. And it's a great way to fill up some areas that you might want to see covered up. So makes it good. Same thing too, and this some of these drier areas here. And when you're doing clouds are just one of those really organic fluid things, so you just want to keep it loose, you know, get good edges, clean edges, bright edges, and then the rest can be soft and kind of disappear almost. Fade into the blue and become its own thing. And that creates a great background. Look at that. It's pretty good so far. Alright, like I said, so you can make it really your own. Little extra things you can always add to. You can always do some stars. Stars are pretty cool. That would be a nice thing since it's blue enough. But it's still a daytime, nighttime scene. So it's really up to you on what you want to do. But that concludes, like say, the top or the first base, first layer of our painting, okay? So I kind of did two layers because the clouds kind of counts as two, but all in all, it's still the same because I just kind of let it add it on to when it's still wet a little bit, so it's not fully dry, all right? Next up, we're gonna do the water. All about the water now. So as I'm teaching, it's hard for me to kind of paint like on the side, and I realized that I should straighten out my horizon line just a little bit more, but it's okay. So the best thing you could do is go over the sky a little bit and straighten it out from when you start with the water. So that's what I'm gonna take this turquoise color, and I'm gonna kind of go in front of it and just see where I need to straighten out my line. Great way to do water. I love to use that turquoise color, but a quick and easy way to kind of get a great effect is to kind of, it's all about how you apply the paint, right? So what we're going to do is, as we're painting, I want to actually add like kind of ripples and kind of moving forms in the paint. So best way to do that is to apply everything while it's still wet, okay? So I'm going to use this dark blue, this turquoise, maybe even a little bit of this this lighter blue, and because it's in the sky, and then plenty of white to cut it up a little bit. So what I like to do by cutting up is this. I can just take a good amount of white and just throw some full squashes, full amounts of water, of white right there. Keep them a little heavy. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna throw in some heavy amounts of color down towards the bottom, and then towards the top we'll use a little bit more of this darker blue. Okay, so it may not look like anything now, but give it a chance. So I'm applying everything a little quick so everything's still wet. All right. Now On a canvas, it works even better because canvas is not absorbing all the paint too quick, but this is what you want to do. Now, with the same brush, if you want, you can kind of just smear it side to side while it's still wet. So that concludes our first base layer. We got the sky up, then we also have the water on the bottom. There you go. All right, guys, now it's time to draw in our pelican, okay? So I have a picture of a pelican here. So when it comes to drawing, that's a whole nother artistic kind of like genre and principles and things like that, so I'm not gonna dive too deep into it, but what I will share with you guys is some quick ideas, quick tidbits on how to, if anyone wants to get better at drawing, great things you want to kind of look into is the fundamentals. So, and my fundamentals is one big one for me is like shapes. Draw with shapes. If you can draw with shapes, you can kind of almost draw anything. But so with my reference, all we want to do is just capture the overall shapes of the pelican, and we're gonna also have him standing on a piece of log. I think this one is a pretty good basic head of the pelican, so I want the head to be fairly in the middle, all right? And it really is important to have a good proper placement, so that's where I wanna do it. I wanna have the head somewhere in here. And the idea is that, you know, the head of the pelican is gonna kind of sit off to the side here. Just like that, we have our sketching, okay? So now it's all about painting. Coming up. All right, now let's paint. Okay, so I got some extra colors here just to kind of add on to it. Okay, first thing we want to do is let's start with the wood kind of log peeking out there. So I have some dark brown burnt umber. And I also have some burnt sienna too, so it's just gonna give us, and then a little bit of that same color helps too. So great way to paint. Without doing much, you could kind of almost see it there, you know, the wood just kind of peering through. And what I want to do is you can use the same brush, or you can use like another brush, like almost like a dry brush. Go over it, why not? Just kind of smear it, caramelize it a little bit, give it a little bit of a feel, just like that. It doesn't have to be perfect. You can actually give it a little bit of imperfections. Why not? And that alone gives you that feeling that you're looking for. And maybe down here could be a little bit darker. Maybe more of the darker stuff. Right there. Is that straight?
Nah,
that's about. Now, of course, if you want to add some darker areas to it, then you can. You can throw in some blue in with that brown, the dark blue. And those two colors together really gives you a darker shade. So maybe now it could be a little bit darker. Is good enough for our wood right there. We're gonna let that dry, and again, we're gonna add some a rope to it. All right, now for the pelican, okay? So I have most of the colors here, and what I like to do is, for any object that I paint or anything like that, I like to do the base color first, the color that's in between the lightest color or the darkest color. Whatever color that is, that'll be the base color. And then from on top of that, you can add the highlights and then the shadows. So it gives you a good idea of what steps I'm thinking in my mind, okay? All right, so first things first, let's do the head. Get really comfortable with this painting thing, you can really start to kind of add the next color after. But typically, sometimes I usually let it dry sometimes if you want to kind of do that. But if you can do it wet on wet, it mixes a little bit better. But you know, you can always overdo it sometimes, so keep it simple. All right, so let's go to the next color. I can actually switch gears, I can actually do the actual beak next. All right, that's a good one to do. So around the neck, and some white. it doesn't have to be as dark. I'm just going to do a gray, because it's going to end up being more light than dark. So gray can help be the middle color. Body, the same thing you want to do too. You want to kind of, especially for right here, within here, you can actually start to add some detail, right? This is the body. So this is the part that's kind of gray. You can see the feathers a little bit towards the middle front area here. So now that things are kind of set a little bit, you can do a few more little touch-ups. Now, since the wings are dry, you can actually really come in and do some detail highlight work with it. So we have a few more things left to do, and then our painting will be done. All right, guys, the last thing we want to do is put our rope in. The rope is fairly easy. I'll show you how to do that. You want to take a beige. It doesn't have to be as dark as everything else. Maybe throw a little bit of that brown in there. Why not? Just give it a little bit of a neutral color. And what you want to do is just throw it in. there. I feel like that's, you know, we got into a fairly completed state. So this is, a quick video that I'd like to, share and spread out to you guys. And I hope you guys enjoyed this simple painting session that I had with you. And definitely feel free to like and to paint some of these, this specific one, if you want to follow step by step. It's totally something anyone can do. It's totally possible. Art is really something that anyone can kind of just dive into and investigate and learn the principles, learn certain techniques and tricks, and you too can do amazing pieces. All right, so I hope you guys enjoy it. My name is Jean Esther with ArtCorner.net, and thanks for painting with me.
Hair to Toes Beauty Tips on BCTV is supported by A Beautiful Transformation Salon.